What's up, Duke fans? After what seemed to be like a pretty brief weekend, we're back with another episode of Duke's 101. Today, I'm sitting down with the man, as we refer to him on campus, Aram Abgaryan, senior tennis player for Duquesne Dukes. Thanks for tuning in to episode 9 of Duke's 101. A little bit about Aram for those who don't know. Aram, you were a 2010 transfer from Loyola Marymount. You were a two-time player of the week in Atlantic 10 in 2011. You were first-team Atlantic 10 performer and then also the player of the year in 2011. Then you were also on the all-academic team in 2011 as well. All right. Finally, after all the accolades, Aram, would you be able to let us know what these accolades mean to you, and then what is the future in the sport of tennis hold for you?
I think the biggest accomplishment was putting Duquesne on the map of the conference, the A-10 conference. I think that was the biggest thing for me. Personal accomplishments weren't really that important. The biggest goal was, somehow put Duquesne on the map. So I think that was my biggest accomplishment at Duquesne, and something I'm really actually happy about. So just getting the program noticed.
What about the future in the sport of tennis? What does that hold for you?
I don't know. Currently winning a conference, the conference championship in Cincinnati. I think short-term goal, do what I can and to win it, to be honest with you. That'll be like the greatest thing ever.
Definitely. Now, Aram, you're originally from Armenia and you live in Calabasas, California on the West Coast. Now, how was that transition for you? Coming from out of the States to the States and then moving from the West Coast to the East Coast for college?
First of all, have you seen Keeping Up with the Kardashians?
I have.
I was there first, for the record. But the transition was rough. First winter here was a little scary. The snow, the cold, just not a big fan. If I can't wear a t-shirt and shorts out, or at least jeans, it's no good. So that was the scariest part, to transfer to the East Coast. And I really haven't spent that much time anywhere on the East Coast, unless it was for traveling for like a week or something. So I think the weather, right? By far the weather.
Yeah, I believe you. I seen you earlier today and you had on a t-shirt and you was like, yo bro, I gotta go home to get a jacket. So definitely you say that the weather transition has been the hardest. Got it. Aram, out of all your career accomplishments thus far, what has been your proudest moment and why?
I think one of the proudest moments was winning Player of the Year, because when I transferred here, I had a pretty rough transition, I guess. I had surgery and it kind of held me back and didn't really do that great, and I really wanted to, but I just, kind of felt I let down the team a little bit. And just bouncing back the next year, practiced really hard in the summer, and just bouncing back in the spring, I think that was one of the biggest things, just playing awful and just struggling to get through, surgery, and just I had to play through it, and just the next year, bouncing back and like no problems, being healthy, it was just amazing.
Definitely. Agreed. All right, now Aram, this part of the show is what we call the 5 on 5, which means you have 5 seconds to answer each of the 5 questions. And we will begin now. First 5 on 5 question. Aram, who has been one of the most influential people within your career so far here at Duquesne?
David Douglas, for sure.
Who is David Douglas?
For the people who don't know, he resides in the training room at all times, and should be called the Swede because all about the deep tissue the massages.
He's the master of the deep tissue massages. Shout out to Dubs. Let's give Dubs a special shout out to Dubs. Second question of the 5 on 5, Aram. What is something that people don't know about you?
I don't sleep.
Third 5 on 5 question. Your favorite place to eat in Cali would be what?
Has to be In-N-Out for sure. It's all about the burgers.
In-N-Out burger, I heard of it, man. Good choice. Oh my God, good choice. I heard about that one. 4 5 5 question. We will go with, what is your favorite place to eat here in Pittsburgh?
I gotta say Lynn's Asian Fusion. I live like 2 doors down, so I think I'm there all the time.
Big shout out there. When you're frustrated on a tennis court. When you're frustrated on the tennis courts, I heard sometimes you're a frustrating guy on the tennis court.
I'm pretty calm, but there's times that...
Can you tell us or even give us a gesture what you do? Can you give us an example?
I can show you a few examples that I have left. Some teams stole them from me. These rackets here.
What you got?
I have three. There's six of them. Some teams stole them. I love these rackets. Probably the best rackets ever made. They had to go. They just had to go. It had to happen. I'm sorry, but not something I'm proud of. But when I get pissed, I break a lot of things. And
show us how you do it.
I mean, I don't want to break the floor here, but I'm gonna have to break the floor. I don't think it'll snap anymore.
All right, last question, Aram. If you could give some advice to a young child who's aspiring to play tennis at the collegiate level, what would that advice be?
Pick up curling instead. If you like not being at home a long period of time, probably getting homeschooled, do it. Just go do it. Do it big. That's all I'm saying. So there's only really one way. If you really want to be playing at the collegiate level and doing well, you got to travel and work really hard on the court, off the court, stay healthy. So I think those things. Get a good coach. That's another huge thing. Make sure you get a really good coach. That's about it, I think.
Appreciate that, Aram. Dukes fans, thanks for tuning in to the latest episode of Dukes 101. I'm Jay Spinks. I'm here with the man, Aram Abgaryan. Thanks for tuning in to episode 9 of Dukes 101. Talk to me, yeah.